You talked about betrayal of the national interest, betrayal of the national interest and corruption of the electoral process. Can you say a little bit more about what the framers' concerns were about corruption of elections and betrayal of the national interest involving foreign powers and how they come into play here?
Sure. So let me start with the framers and what they were concerned with and then bring it up to date, because I think there's some modern stuff as well that's important. So the framers were very worried that elections could be corrupted. They could be corrupted in a variety of different ways, and they spent a lot of time trying to design an election system that wouldn't be subject to that kind of corruption. And there are a number of different provisions in the Constitution that deal with the kinds of corruption they were worried about. Two that I'd just like to highlight here, because I think they go to this idea about the national interest and foreign governments, are one that seems today, I think, to most of us to be really a kind of remnant of a past time, which is if you become an American citizen, almost everything in this country is open to you. You can become Chief Justice of the United States. You can become Secretary of State. But the one office that's not open to you, even though you're a citizen just like all of the rest of us, is the presidency, because of the natural born citizen clause of the Constitution. And the reason they put that in is they were so worried about foreign influence over a president. The other clause, which, you know, probably no one had heard of,